Carolina Hurricanes owner Peter Karmanos.
Karmanos.
I apologize. Peter Karmanos is having trouble selling the franchise. Karmanos announced last summer that he was looking to divest himself of the Hurricanes for something like $400 million. After more than 20 years of ownership, those are noble succession plans. So, you know, some of his critics would say that, you know, he stuck in there for 20 years and he should eat the grapes, you know, the fruits of the sacrifice. And but he's got no takers.
Not at $400 million, Frank.
Yeah.
Not at $400 million.
But isn't $400 million what they're going to go for, or they're what? Like, I mean, this guy's a very bright businessman. The family's been in sports. They have a lot of different businesses, right?
Yeah.
He wouldn't be stupid and put a billion-dollar tag on something unless he knew that that's what the value of the franchise is.
Well, yeah, I know where you're coming from, Frank. I just know that no one is going to buy the Carolina Hurricanes for $400 million.
So what you're saying is nobody's going to buy a small market team at the top price. It's like buying a house a house in Toronto's $2 million. That same house in a different part, like, let's say, North Bay or Sudbury, because land is a different value there, should be $300,000, $400,000, $500,000 less. So nobody's going to buy the same house in North Bay or Sault Ste. Marie or Thunder Bay, the same price is in Toronto. Is that what you're saying? So $400 million might be the right price for a big market team like the Detroit Red Wings, the Toronto Maple Leafs?
Well, obviously.
Not for a small market team.
Yeah, well, when you can buy the Ottawa Senators for $25 million, why should you have to pay? And the only way that transaction will go down is if Gary Bettman finds a buyer, and he says, look, I want to get Peter Karmanos out of this. I want you to buy that franchise for $400 million, and I will guarantee you, you'll be in Quebec City in 2017, and you'll have $100 million in your jeans.
But what about the Quebec City expansion bid?
Well, no, I'm talking about Markham, Quebec City. They have to find a spot.
Right.
Carolina or Florida. They'd love to move Carolina to the west for
those
reasons, but they may not be able to. So, Bettman, he's already put the Florida guy on notice, the pitcher there, what was his name, the left-hander. But Bettman can control that within reason, and they have to believe in Bettman. Whoever buys it may not be a friend of Peter Karmanos's, but he might buy it for $300 million. And he knows that he's got an out at 4 or 4.5 or 5.
I think you hit the nail on the head. I think that Karmanos is banking on the ownership of Markham, who really wants a team badly, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they would pay the $400 million to move the team. But nobody in their right mind would spend $400 million and keep the team in Carolina, because you're not going to make the revenue to substantiate that major investment.
Nowhere close.
Peter Karmanos has lost a lot of money, but he bought the Hartford Whalers for $30 million.
Wow.
So even if that team lost $10 million a year, for 20 years, he lost $200 million.
That's right.
So $200 million, add interest and whatever, let's call it, he's going to break even if he sells it for $400 million in my books.
I would say so, Frank. Be pretty close. You know, they've had some tough years, but since revenue sharing has become such a big part of it, and he also owns the rights to that arena for all other events other than NCAA basketball.
What other sports franchises does that family own?
Oh, no, they were in Detroit. They owned the CompuWare. They owned the Windsor Spitfires. They owned CompuWare in the junior. They owned a team in Fort Myers, Florida, in the ECHL. But Peter's money was in CompuWare, the software company. My wife and I, the Duchess, had the honor of going to his second wedding. With Peter Karmanos.
He's a very astute and very smart guy, but he's loved sports. And
he's a lot of money into sports, whether it be the minors.
Wasn't he going to buy a basketball team once? Did I not read that he was going to buy a basketball team once?
No. Hockey is, he loves hockey. And his partner died about 2 years ago, and that's when Peter started looking to sell it.
Because he bought out his partner's interest.
His partner's
family.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I would say, what I'm saying is, if he paid $25 million for the franchise 20 years ago and he lost a substantial amount of money every year, I would say that if he gets $400 million, it's like basically breaking even.
Yep. Yeah, I think that's fair. And
so he's not, he's kept the team for 20 years. He's not being stupid. And also, I believe that a team who wants to expand, like the Markham Group or anybody else would have a chance to with the NHL, that would probably make Bettman happy.
Yeah, Bettman's got a few of those, though. Like, he's going to move Phoenix to Seattle or something like that. So he's got to, if his expansion fee is $500, how can he sell an established team for less?
Yeah.
Exactly.